Tesla's secret weapon, the insane GigaPress in action. The world has changed a great deal over the years. What was once an imagination or a dream for someone is now a beautiful and spectacular reality. There was a time when the very existence of vehicles was just an imagination. When German inventor Carl Benz built the first vehicle in 1886, everyone was amazed. Hundreds of years later, Elon Musk is revolutionizing the entire automobile industry. What Tesla has accomplished is just phenomenal. They have not only restructured vehicles, but they have changed how vehicles are made. One of the most impressive improvements from Tesla is the use of monster machines. This was expected of the electric car industry anyway. But how are those new machines being used? Hello and welcome back to our channel. Today, we're taking a look at the monster machine that Tesla uses to make its cars, the GigaPress. Remember to leave a like on the video and subscribe to our channel for more videos. With that said, let's have a look at this monster machine. These machines are changing the whole face of auto manufacturing in the car industry. Tesla has been using other GigaPresses to accelerate the production of its cars. However, they still want bigger and better. They started working on a bigger and larger monster machine than the one that was already there. This one will be capable of producing single cast pieces for Tesla vehicles. Its weight is similar to that of not one, not two, but four SpaceX rockets. One can only imagine how many flatbed trucks it takes to deliver this big boy. Given its mass and size, it does not even fit inside the original Tesla factory. So why the new GigaPress? What's different compared to the other GigaPresses? What inspired the manufacturer of this new GigaPress? Elon Musk is a man who is driven, and he will stop at nothing until he fulfills his mission. To him, the statement, "Innovation never stops," is literal. He endlessly finds new ways to make his day job at Tesla be more interesting. He does love a good challenge. Reports indicate that a Hot Wheels car sitting on his desk is what inspired his latest idea. He thought about the die-cast of the car and wondered what the ideal size limit should be. He finally came to the idea that there is no limitation. He concluded that a full-size auto should be manufactured according to the same size philosophy. During the manufacturing of Tesla's new Model Y, Elon Musk concluded that the complex process of screwing, welding, and gluing the parts of the rear of the body of the Model Y was quite difficult. Sometimes it proved to be a nearly impossible task. For a few years now, Tesla has been really focused on costing new technology that would produce larger parts of its vehicles in bigger pieces. Elon Musk has been working hard to complete this mission. Finally, he was able to purchase two of the biggest casting machines. They were both installed in a factory in Vermont and started operating in 2020. The machine, which is now known as the GigaPress, is the first of its kind. It was made by the IDRA group in Italy. Instead of handling 70 pieces of metal, it handles a single die cast. This was confirmed to be true on Tesla's official Twitter page. The GigaPress made a very huge change in both the production and design for Tesla. Musk says that in addition to reducing the manufacturing costs and complexity of the car, it also reduces its weight. What is the advantage of the GigaPress? It was revealed that it makes the battery packs right after it starts making the front end. When the three parts are made through die casting, the test level eliminates about 370 parts. In addition to this, the GigaPress also eliminates manufacturing robot machines. According to Musk, a total of 300 robots from the manufacturing of the rear end of the single cast were replaced. Assuming that even from the front end, 300 robots were also replaced, this means a total of 600 robots were replaced. These 600 robots are only for the manufacturing of the front and rear. Also, keep in mind that it is also before getting the battery packing robots. It is without a doubt that the battery packing robots are fast. The only problem is that they take a lot of time and effort to set up. They have to be accurately set up, firmly attached to the factory floor, and tested thoroughly to make sure that they are accurate enough in their operation. In addition to this, they also require constant maintenance if you want to preserve their accuracy and speed. Now we can see why Tesla tried all they could to get rid of them. However, isn't it ironical that these very robots were the main cause of humans losing their jobs? Now they are being disposed of, all thanks to the GigaPress. Guess who's losing their jobs now? Now that you think about it, Tesla had a really tough time managing their operations before the GigaPresses came. They held on for as long as they could, but eventually Elon Musk knew that die casting was the best and most efficient way to make cars. The question at hand is whether every other car manufacturer will follow Tesla or will they fall behind. Musk himself believes that at least some electric car manufacturers will follow suit and start using GigaPresses to make their cars. The refreshed version of the Tesla Model Y is expected to be the most advanced vehicle in the history of Tesla. Well, only up until Elon Musk decides that he is bored with it and decides to invent an even more advanced model than the Model Y. It was said that it would be put together in Texas and Berlin. In August, it was said that the Gigafactories in Texas had started receiving deliveries of parts of a 6,000-ton GigaPress, the one that would be used for the production of the Model Y. However, Tesla was already building the substructure of GigaPress number 4. According to the evidence, this means that Tesla is creating two different borders for the front and rear end. This leads to the conclusion that Tesla might be creating two different versions of the Model Y. However, the truth in this is yet to be confirmed. Rumor has it that Tesla may be moving the production of the Model Y from Vermont to Texas. This nullifies the above conclusion. However, it is no surprise that Tesla needs something that is powerful enough to make the bigger pieces that will be part of the Cybertruck. The Cybertruck is a big monster truck that is said to be twice the size of the Model Y. IDRA announced that a leading global manufacturer of new energy vehicles has placed an order for an 8,000-ton capacity GigaPress. This GigaPress is definitely for making pickup trucks and other bigger vehicles in terms of size. This was announced to reports from IDRA. We all know that Tesla has ordered an 8,000-ton GigaPress. However, Elon Musk steering the ship, who knows how many GigaPresses that are more powerful will be used. A 12,000-ton GigaPress would be available to manufacture an entire substructure of the vehicle. It would be capable of making 25,000 affordable electric cars, which Musk has been trying to make for years. The GigaPresses will become part of Tesla's Gigafactories from now on. Fewer parts means less waste and better quality. This is what places Tesla ahead of all of the other electric car companies. As the old automotive companies try to adopt the ICE car body to make electric vehicles, Tesla changes its ways and moves further ahead. Tesla has had a very great impact on the automotive industry. Musk has shown that once you master the basics of any field, then you have the chance to be as innovative as you like till you change the world. He is setting the pace in the global automotive industry. He has shown that innovation is not only in the power unit to energize automobiles. Tesla continues to improve and innovate, and the GigaPress puts it way ahead of other companies. So, what do you think of the new GigaPress? Do you think that it was a great move for the company? Let us know in the comments section below. If you enjoyed the video, then don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Also, hit the bell notification to get notified of new videos. Until next time, bye.